All hail the almighty and glorious overlord, Michael Fassbender. Alien fans, did you guys see this yet? Friend just passed this along. Alien Covenant, the Alien Covenant prologue, which I don't think is a part of the movie. So I think this is a little viral thing that 20th Century Fox just released to us. And if I'm reading the description right, it looks like it actually reveals what happens to Robot David, Synthetic David, and Elizabeth Shaw, Newbie's characters. So they're not in the new movie, right? So this is kind of cool. This is bridging some gaps here. And this is why I love Ridley. Okay, let's check out the prologue together, guys. 2098, Prometheus Expedition went looking for humanity's creators. The mission ended in disaster after the discovery of a deadly alien pathogen. The survivors continue their search.
After we made contact with the engineers, the Prometheus was destroyed. All hands were lost, but I escaped with Elizabeth in one of their ships. I was badly injured on our mission. She put me back together. I'd never experienced such compassion.
I was gonna say, it's just a head.
From Mr. Wayland, or from any human.
Green to green, red to red.
I love that synth sound.
It's meant to be simple.
I'm doing my best.
You're very kind at heart, you know.
We were able to activate their ship and set course for their homeworld. We were finally going to meet our creators.
How long?
Impossible to say.
What if they're no better than us?
So long as they are no worse. Sleep tight. I'll wake you when we arrive.
She's going down.
And then I was alone again. I learned of their ways and awaited our arrival.
Look on my works, you mighty, and despair.
God damn it. Okay, so that was that the homeworld? Did they get sidetracked? Was that the actual homeworld? That's the engineer's homeworld right there. I mean, yes, it had a badass dock. But the actual buildings and stuff, they looked kind of earthly. Like, look at those buildings right there. That's very much, I don't know, that's highly resembling of our architecture. But then again, they made us, right? So, and this, maybe this is just one of their cities. I mean, probably, it's just one of their cities. Wow, and they just let our spaceship, maybe we tricked them, I don't know. Maybe, I feel like they would have the technology to know that, oh, one of our creations is coming back and infiltrating our, not infiltrating, but is visiting us. I don't know. Interesting. So does this play into the movie Covenant? Is there going to be some sort of reference? If you noticed, there was an actual log he was keeping, an audio log that provided some of the narration for this prologue. So I'm wondering if that audio log will come into play in Covenant. Like maybe they'll come across it at some point, or maybe it was like beamed out. I don't know. At some point, maybe they'll come across it and they will have kind of an insight into what they found out about the engineers. Very cool. Very cool. And another thing, he put Numi down. He put Elizabeth Shaw down in cryo sleep, right? So there was no sign that he woke her. Is he kind of going to do this thing alone? handle the introductions to the alien species alone. It's kind of trippy, right? You have the makers, the engineers. You have a robot, which is not a direct creation of the engineers, but it's a creation of a creation, right? It's almost like a third tier evolution, like third tier creation here going on, making the actual contact. So I don't know. It's kind of cool how it's crossing over into like Skynet Terminator territory almost. Not quite, but definitely pulling some elements from there possibly. Interesting. Take a look at the world. I did expect the engineer's homeworld to look a bit different, I guess, maybe for some reason. But then again, who are we to say, right? Who are we to say that it wouldn't look earthly? I don't know. They didn't make us, so I mean, we're rooted in them. So they came first, so maybe they just selected Earth as a planet. Because it had a lot of the same, had similarities to their home planet. In David's quote, so long as there are no worse. Is that a prelude to something in regards to Covenant? Is there going to be a connection with the engineers in Covenant in which they made us, though? You know what I mean? They made us. So why would they wish for our demise? Like, there's no... I don't know. Here we go. This is it. This is why everyone's talking. So, all right. What do you guys think? How is this going to relate, if anyway, into the events that take place in Alien Covenant? That's the reaction question for today. It definitely fills in some gaps in terms of actually physically what happens to the survivors of Prometheus, but then again, it brings up a lot of additional questions as well. But I'm glad Ridley's at the helm. I'm glad he's expanding this universe to us because, I mean, if you guys are talking sci-fi, especially horror sci-fi, this is the bread and butter here. This is the franchise that you give a shit about, so... All right, let me know your thoughts, guys. I'm kind of curious what you think. All right, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you guys in the comments.